Okay, so let's continue where we left off last time. So last time we were doing some shaping. We got some of the head area done, and so in this video we have to continue to shape. First, we do go to edit, delete by type history, so that we can delete our history for now. It's always a good thing to do that. So we continue to shape. Let me fit selection here. So let's continue shaping. Let me grow the selection. I'm going to press B for soft selection. Let me increase the radius and grab this. Maybe reposition and scale that down slightly. So it's always a good thing to just continue to shape and develop the form that you're looking for. And it can be a slow process, but eventually you'll get to a point where you think that you got the overall shape matching to the image. So just continue to do more shaping. Again, I wanted to show everything that I do in the shaping process so that you have an idea. Let's look at the images here. And then probably we need to start thinking about adding the nostrils here, or at least what I think could be the nostrils, especially. Now this one doesn't have that, but we're going to add it anyway. So I'm going to select this face. And I'm probably going to edit mesh and extrude. Now before, let me turn reflection off. So if you look what reflection did, it selected the whole object when I extrude it. So that's why I'm going to turn that disable reflection at this point. Now let's enable reflection. Let me select this loop so that I can type 0 here. So get that back into place. Maybe G to extrude one more time. Looks a little too strong, so let's move some of the edges around to soften that area. This is technically the nostrils, or at least what I think are the nostrils in the pictures. Okay, so I'm going to select this edge and I'm going to edit mesh, spin edge forward, and press G. Now what I did there was it allowed to change the edge flow. I just wanted to soften that area of the nostrils. So all I did was spin that edge. So now let's continue to shape. So that spin edge loop tool is really helpful if you want to change the edge flow. Let's go to mesh and use the sculpt geometry tool. Let me change the radius. I'm just going to relax some of this area here using this sculpt geometry tool set to relax. It helps sometimes when you have really hard edges. Just press Q to exit. Now press Control Spacebar, so that you get more screen space. Whenever you tap Control Spacebar, you get more screen space. So let's continue to shape. So at this point, it's a good idea just to continue to shape until you're happy with the results that you're getting. Again, all I'm doing is shaping. I know it could be boring, but it can be boring just to watch me doing this, but sometimes it's helpful. So moving some edges with the combination of soft selection to create that form. I want to get the neck slightly rounder here. So I'm just going to move some of the edges. Again, I'm just moving edges. I'm using soft selection. And of course, you're not bound to just moving the edges. You can remember you can move faces and vertices, not just edges. Now, let me just redefine the form here for the leg. I mean, right now it's all about shaping, getting that form. Don't worry, we're gonna get to all the other details in a minute here, so that we can get back to the head and the feet. We continue to look at that picture of the background that we have here so that you can closely resemble our form here to the image. Of course, we don't have a frontal view, but we're gonna have to work with that, with what we have. We might want to start thinking about make creating the feet. I think this picture is really helpful, so we can see the toes. And I think I can see that, especially in this picture, I believe he only has three toes. But for now, we're going to continue to shape. We're going to get that in a minute here. Soft selection is really, really helpful when it comes to shaping these things. So we just continue to shape. And just looking at that picture that I have here in the back, that side view image. And I couldn't find a picture of a back view, so I'm going to have to kind of guess how that looks. I'm not too happy with this area here, but I might come back to that later. Just try to get as close as possible to maybe a combination of all the images that we have. I mean, they all have, they're very similar anyways. So, and it's the same dinosaur, I suppose. So I think for now we're going to stop here and we're going to continue next time. I think next time we're going to get to the teeth and maybe get the toes done and slightly more shaping. Of course, we always have to continue to shape. So we're going to stop here for now. So we'll continue next time, okay?